You know, I think that really being an activist is being an artist. And the fact of the matter is, we would be nowhere without our arts. We cannot survive the work that we do without our artists. So, and activists, and I'm so thrilled our final program today includes the incredible youth ensemble from here in Denver. It's called the Cleo Parker Robinson Youth Ensemble. And no one can tell you about it better than its founder, Cleo Parker Robinson. Please welcome.
Hey, good morning. Let me see, I want to see all the way back there. Wonderful. This is awesome. This is phenomenal. You know, I want to dance for you, but I want to dance with you. So I want you to finish your beautiful meals, and we've thanked everyone, but I think you have to thank yourselves for knowing where to be today in Denver at this moment, at this conference, and knowing that you are creating change. I've had my company for 44 years here in Denver, and we've been around the world, actually. We just got back from Savannah, Georgia, yesterday, and we're on our way to Mexico City in the morning. And we know how important art is in everyone's life. But not everyone feels that they can express themselves because of our systems and our community. So what you have done today is created a greater community, not only for this country, but for the globe. Give yourselves a hand. Yes. My company, this really is not my youth ensemble. I have a youth ensemble. We have a second company. But when I knew you were coming, I said, we're coming off the plane. And the company is going to perform. And that's right. And we have a little space, but we're going to create space here. That's right. And then what I'd like to do is share with you what this is about. The company has been a part of a community that has really thought that dance was a dirty word, and thought that people of different genders and different colors and different cultures, we never came together. And so that separatism really separated us, and we felt like people were feeling elitist, but we felt that that was very ignorant. And people really have to know each other, and we find each other through the arts. And in training every day, training our minds and our bodies and our spirits. Ashe. Mm-hmm. So the dancers are coming out. And they're going to do three works for you, three little ditties, excerpts. The first work is called Lush Life, a piece that I created with Dr. Maya Angelou in 1983. Yes. So we created this piece at her home in North Carolina, North Kakalaki. That's right. North Carolina's in the house. So this piece was wonderful because it was her poetry. And it was the music and the dance, and we did it live. And so I've kept a little ditty there. But what I want you to know about Dr. Angelou and what she had to say was that anybody in her home, if anyone spoke out against anyone and had any shady jokes about anyone, whether it was about gender or race or language or culture, she asked them to remove themselves and leave. So she was an activist every day. And I think it inspires us to do just that, that when it doesn't feel right, we speak that right moment, right at that moment. But this time, we're going to do a little ditty. So she loved dancing. She was a dancer first. And so we're going to do a little bit of Lush Life. Then we're going to go into a solo called Blackbird. And then I'd like to finish it with Rennie Harris, who is a marvelous choreographer. Yes, he's one of the top hip-hop artists in the world at this point, and it's called Free with a Question Mark. And so we're always talking about, are we really free? So today, you helped us become more liberated, and so give yourselves a hand for liberating not only yourselves, but others. So here we go. We're going to start by dancing for you, and we're going to end by dancing with you. Are you ready to dance? All right. All right, and then I'd like the dancers to introduce themselves because they come from all over the country, and I'd like to introduce Millicent Johnny, who is here with me from New Orleans. And she's one of the baddest choreographers that exist, and we're working on a piece called Bambula. So it really, we keep sort of destroying stereotypes about people, so we love that. All right, let's dance. Here we go. Let's live.
Thank you. singing in the dead of night. Take these broken wings and learn to fly all your life. You're only waiting for this moment to arrive. Blackbird singing in a dead of night. Take these sunken eyes and learn to see.
شوفوا لنا ورقان بعض ضرب عدوا في الماس ينا عدوا في الماس ينا عدوا في الماس ما رد عليهم خالد من المولى ينتقل ما رد عليهم خالد من المولى ينتقل شوفوا لنا وركان بعض ضرب الماء نازل شوفوا لنا وركان بعض ضرب الماء نازل بدو ذاك وعادي عدوا في الماء ينا عدوا في الماء ينا عدوا في
We're going to have some unity here. We're going to have some unity to solve all of our problems. For us, the only politics in this country that's relevant to black people today is the politics of revolution. None other. The only thing that's going to free Huey is gunpowder. Black powder. Black people become serious about the revolutionary struggle that they are caught up in, whether they recognize it or not, when they begin to go down and knock off people who are oppressing them and begin to render these people impotent, that's when the revolutionary struggle unfolds. Not until.
Like anybody, I would like to live a long life. Longevity has its place. But I'm not concerned about that now. I just want to do God's will. And He's allowed me to go up to the mountain.
got beaten did not strike back. The people who got beaten did not have weapons with them. It was just a stroke of genius.
Woo! Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you. Woo! Thank you, thank you, thank you. Yeah. Woo! Oh, my goodness. Woo! Wow, 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 wow. This feels good. That's all I can say. Thank you. Whoa. So we celebrate 50 years of the civil rights movement, and in that, we fought for rights for everybody, and I'm so proud of being from my mother and father, because my father is black and my mother's white, and they fought in Denver, not in the South, but right here, where we had the Klan, and they couldn't come across the streets, and there was prejudice against Jews, against gays, against everybody, and they fought for everyone's rights. So today, when I look around this room, my heart is happy. That's all I can say. I am just very, very happy. Happy, happy, happy for all the work. We want to introduce the dancers very quickly, because I know you have planes and trains to catch. But before I say the dancers' names, they're going to say them themselves. And I'm just proud of them. Not all of them are here, but they will be getting on a plane another day. We'll be performing in Guadalajara. If anybody's going to be there, we'll be there Saturday night. Uh-huh. And we were in Savannah, Georgia a few nights ago. But I want to say, Denver is our home, and they come from everywhere, but we run a year-round school with children from the age of 1.5, and they all teach. And I'm so proud that they are teachers, because we have to go into the schools and change the systems right there. That's where the systems have to change. Absolutely. And we just finished a piece about black and brown men and people of color and without the means and the systems of incarceration, and that has to change, and that's what we're working on now. Millicent Johnny will be with us next. When we come back from Guadalajara, we will be working on a piece with Millicent Johnny about Bambula, and we'll be working with two composers that are one classical musician and one Donald Harrison, who is a chief, an Indian chief in New Orleans, and so we're very proud. But we have a summer institute, and I want you to know, right here in Denver, children will be coming from everywhere in the country to study with us in July. And then in January, we'll be in this room for the International Black Dance Conference and dancers from Duke Ellington. And I love it because, from all over the world. But Nikki Davis just said she saw me in 1974, and I told her that wasn't me. I'm not that old. So now I want the dancers to introduce themselves. You can find us at Cleo Parker. dance.org, and just come and visit us anytime, but enjoy the weather. We made it so, uh-huh. We left when it was snowing, and we knew y'all were coming, so we said, don't snow, uh-huh. Here we go. Here, let's introduce all the dancers.
Hey, y'all. I'm Christopher Frazier. I'm from Oklahoma City, Oklahoma, and this is my third season with the company.
I'm Edgar. I'm from Detroit, Michigan, and this is my fifth year in the company.
Good afternoon. Okay. Good afternoon. I am Sadia Imari. I'm from South Carolina, and this is my fourth season. Yay! And this is my fourth season dancing with Cleo Parker Robinson.
All righty. Good afternoon. I'm Cedric Dwayne Hall from Cleveland, Ohio, and this is... All right. And this is my ninth year with the company.
Hi, my name is Amelia. I'm originally from Logan, Ohio, and this is my third season in the company.
Hello, my name is Chloe Abel. I'm from Kansas City, Missouri, and this is my This is also my third year in the company.
Good afternoon. I am Chris Page. I am from St. Louis, Missouri. All right, yeah. And this is my sixth year with the company. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. My name is Roxanne Young. I'm from Denver, Colorado. And this is also my third year in the company.
All right. You know, I felt the dance in this room, and then everything was shaking and carrying on. But I want to thank your executive director. Where's Ray Carey? And I want to thank everybody who made this happen today. Ray, come on up. Come on up. And where is Cece? I know it's time to dance. She was fabulous. We thank everyone that worked so hard to make this conference happen, and just keep up the good work. And I want you all to dance. I want to see you up. I want you to dance, and I want you to hug. I want you to keep that heart chakra working, even when you get back home and get back home safely. We love you from Denver, and let's put on the music, and we're coming out to dance with y'all. Here we go.